Yes, so here is the chapter. We are going to revise the chapter, The Portrait of a Lady by Khushwant Singh. So this chapter, The Portrait of a Lady, is an autobiographical account. It is autobiographical. That is, it is about Khushwant Singh's own life. So in this step, from this chapter, we also come to know like what went into the making of this Khushwant Singh. Okay, let me now cover up in a few words. Okay, Japan Jot. So it is a chapter which is an autobiographical account of Khushwant Singh, one of the most prolific writer of India. Okay, the one who is very famous for the book like The Train to Pakistan. And Khushwant Singh is also very famous for the write-ups he writes for the magazines or for the newspapers, especially his way of his satirical way of write-up, the way he comments upon the system or upon the society, that is, you know, very unique about him. He is known for the humor, you know, in his write-ups. That's why his satires, S-A-T-I-R-E-S, that's why his satires upon the society, you know, they have given him a special name in the world of literature. So in this chapter, when we talk about such a great person, then sometimes it comes to our mind like what kind of childhood he might have had. So that kind of how he might have been brought up in the beginning. So how his parents might have groomed him. So here are the things which we come to know about this kind of Khushwant Singh. So it is autobiographical. It is about the about how he was brought up in the early years of his childhood. So the kind of impression he has from his parents and grandparents. So the kind of life he became quite prolific. He became quite a great writer later on. But as a child, what he was, how he was, you know, brought up by his parents. The kind of situations he was given. So these things, you know, help us realize that yes, in order to make a child become great in later life, you know, the childhood, the kind of grooming he is given, that matters a lot. So what kind of grooming was he given? He was given a simple lifestyle. So the kind of simplicity which was instilled in his character, the whole credit goes to his parents and then especially to his grandmother. So here when we talk about the portrait of a lady, so here the portrait is the portrait, pen portrait of grandmother. So what kind of portrait is there? It's the pen portrait. So here the Khushwant Singh is not giving a, you know, drawing it. He's not making a sketch of the grandmother. He is giving the pen portrait of grandmother, the kind of pen portrait through which we come to know, through which we are able to perceive like how the grandmother might be looking like, how she used to walk about, how she used to, you know, behave, how she used to react to certain situations. So this story is actually a complete pen portrait of the grandmother of Khushwant Singh and Khushwant Singh's write-up style, you know, it becomes quite clear that his writing style is very, very crystal clear. It is because of the words he uses to describe his grandmother that makes this pen portrait one of the most prolific write-ups in Indian literature. Okay, so here is the grandmother who is being described by Khushwant Singh through this chapter, and he describes that his grandmother used to be a short, bent, and she used to be a short, bent woman with white sari. So this was her physical description. She was a short and bent lady with her, with, and she used to wear white spotless sari. So the wearing of white spotless sari is also symbolic of her serene and tranquil nature. So what made her have a serene and tranquil nature? So the grandmother was very serene and tranquil. Serene and tranquil means at peace. The one who had no never at disturbance. So the grandmother was a very serene and tranquil person. So what gave her this serenity? It's my question from you. What gave her that serene personality? Yes, give the answer. Let me give you options for this. What gave this woman, what gave the grandmother a serene personality? Number one, let me give you the options. Was it the white sari? Options are white sari. Second, her cool and calm nature. Third, her belief, her spirituality. And number four, her indifference towards the world. Indifference attitude towards the world. My question is, what made the grandmother become serene and tranquil? The options are number one, white sari. Second, spirituality. Third, her calm and cool nature. And number four, her indifferent attitude towards the world. So what is the correct answer for this question? Because you'll be getting the MCQs. Who will give answer? Chirag Ahuja, unmute yourself. Chirag Ahuja, unmute yourself. Himanshu, I did not speak this language. Your answer is though correct, but I did not speak this. Samrithi, you are right. Your answer is correct. Who is 25 roll number? Kavya. Kavya, no beta. My question is, what made her have serene personality? What made her serene? Options are white sari. Number two, spirituality. Number three, her calm and cool nature. Number four, her indifferent attitude towards the world. So what's the correct answer? So those who know, only one child has given the correct answer so far and Chirag Ahuja is not giving answer. Unmute yourself, Chirag. Okay, Abhay, roll number one, unmute yourself. Abhay. Okay, Gursirat Singh, roll number 18.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Gursirat, what's the answer?
Ma'am, simple lifestyle.
The question is, what made the grandmother serene? Options are spirituality, calm and cool nature, white sari, or her indifference towards the world. Dhruv, do you know? Which one? What's the answer? Huh? Indifference attitude towards the world. Okay, Dhruv over is there and he says indifferent attitude towards the world. So what do you say, Gursirat beta? Hurry up.
Ma'am, spirituality.
Yes. Why are you giving?
Ma'am, first option.
Yeah, your answer is correct. It is spirituality. Her spirituality made her serene. Though the other options were not wrong, I told you that she used to wear white sari. okay, white sari, white color is symbolic of peace. But yes, it doesn't make you, it gives you peace outwardly. But in order to become inwardly also at peace or serene, you know, you need to have something inside. And that strength from within comes from spirituality. So the grandmother had become a very serene person. She was at complete peace with herself or with the world outside because she was a very spiritual person. Okay? Her spirituality made her totally at peace with herself and with the world outside. That's why she was never able to, she never ever reacted to the situations which were cropping up in her life. So there were so many situations which cropped up in her life, which might have made her become disturbed, which might have made her annoyed, but that never happened because she was serene from within. And the reason for her being so serene and tranquil from within was that she was spiritual in the core. She was spiritual. Okay, spirituality is not about worshipping God in one or the other form. Spirituality is when you exercise it in your character. That she was. Right? So I was talking about that grandmother had become a very serene and tranquil person because she was a hardcore spiritual person. Her spirituality had made her so cool that she never bothered like what was happening around her. Even if children minded, the life is never smooth. So in her life, in her case also, her life was not smooth. In the village, she would take care of her grandson all alone. She would take care of her food. She would take care of her school. She would take care of her, other things. But she would always do the things in a very, very organized and calm manner. She was never rushing about. Okay. So that the way she was brought up by her grandmother in the early childhood of Khushwant Singh, that helped Khushwant Singh, number one, become a balanced personality right from beginning. Then when they went to school, when they went to the city, then there the Khushwant Singh, that is the grandson and grandmother, they would see less of each other. Why would they see less of each other? The options are, the grandmother and grandson would see less of each other in the city. Number one, options are, number one, grandmother could not accompany her grandson to school. Second option, Khushwant Singh, now the grandson was in an English medium school, which grandmother could not understand. Third, the grandson used to study, grandson had started studying music, which grandmother did not approve of. Number four, the grandson would go to school in an auto, in a bus, school bus. So grandmother could not accompany him to school. My question was, grandmother and grandson would see less of each other. The option number one was, the reason you have to tell, the grandson would go by bus to school. So now the grandmother could not accompany him to school. Second, the grandson had started learning music, so she did not approve of it and they would see less of each other. Third reason was that now the grandson had started going to the school and grandmother could not accompany him to school. Simple reason I'm giving you. Number four, what was the fourth reason I had given, Dhruv? This I've spoken.
Yes,
this also I've spoken. Yeah, it was an English medium school and grandmother did not understand anything of it. So out of these four reasons, what is the most correct answer to, they saw less of each other? What was the most appropriate option? Japanjot will tell us. Japanjot, first raise hand. Instantly raise hand. Okay. Give the answer, beta. Unmute yourself. Yes, now speak. Good morning.
Ma'am, that grandma could not accompany him to the school.
They saw less of each other. The reasons were, number one, grandmother could not accompany him to school. Or is it the best answer? Because all the options were correct, that you might have seen children. All the options were correct. But we have to choose one most appropriate option. So what is that? Anyone else? Okay, Japanjot, it's okay, beta. Anyone else who says something else? Dhruv Agarwal, unmute yourself. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What do you think is the correct answer?
Yeah.
Yes, Dhruv, again, you have muted yourself. ओके अभय आर यू
मैम कि मैम वो जब जैसे अर्बन सिटी स्कूल में था तो जब वो घर पे आता था तो वो उसको लेसंस नहीं दे पाते थे लेसंस में मतलब उसकी मदद नहीं कर पाते थे सीखने में
बट यू कैन स्पीक दिस इन इंग्लिश आल्सो बट एनीवेज यू आर सेइंग दैट शी कुड नॉट हेल्प हिम इन हिज लेसंस सो दे स्टार्टेड सीइंग लेस ऑफ ईच अदर सो कैन यू ट्राई टू गिव वन आंसर वन बेस्ट आंसर I already told you, like, all the options are correct. If you are to write this answer in about 100 words or 50 words, then all these points will come, no doubt. But now, because you have to answer the question in just one word, that is one option is to be correct. Which option will you choose? Samriddhi, yes.
My grandson goes to school by bus, so grandmother could not accompany him to school.
Okay. So now they would see less of each other because basically in the very morning, the son would go to school. Japanjot and Samriddhi, you are both right. So basically in the very morning, the grandson would go to school by bus and he would come back in the afternoon. So during all this time, they could not be together because he would go by bus and she could not accompany him to school. And in the village, what used to happen? She would accompany him to school. Then the grandson would be there in the adjoining building. And then they would come back together. So all that time of grandson was spent alone without grandmother, right? First is that this reason. So this is the best reason, like they started seeing less of each other because of this one first main reason. And the other reason was like now the grandson was studying in an English medium school and grandmother did not understand those subjects. And third reason was grandson told her that he had started learning music and grandmother did not approve of it. She did not say anything, but yet she spoke less to grandson after this. Got it? So, and one more. So basically these three reasons are enough for us to give point that they started seeing less of each other because of these three reasons. And the first is that now the grandson would go to school by bus. And now she could not accompany him to school. Is that clear? So children, the point is that you will have to see like what is the most important, what is sequence wise number one reason for your answer. But suppose in this answer, I skip this point. I skip this option about the fact like that he used to go to school by bus. Then what would be your answer? Then what will be your answer? Will it be like he started studying in English medium school and she did not understand those subjects? Or that he had started learning music and she did not speak of? So from here, the answer will be now this option that now he had started studying English medium school where he could not help him in his lessons. So the sequence also you'll have to keep in mind when the MCQs would be there. Okay, now my next question is, when the grandmother comes to know that her grandson had started learning music, she became quiet. She did not speak anything. What does it show about grandmother? What does it show about grandmother? The options are: she was indifferent towards her grandson. She became indifferent towards her grandson. Second option, she started hating her grandson that he was learning music. Third reason, she chose to be quiet on this matter. She chose to be quiet on this matter. And number four, she did not want to create an unpleasantness in the house. She didn't want to create unpleasantness in the house. So what is the most correct answer out of these four? The question is, the grandmother comes to know that her grandson was learning music in the school. She did not like it. And after this, she stopped talking to her grandson. It's not like altogether she stopped talking to her grandson. And after this, what she did actually? She became indifferent towards her grandson. She started hating her grandson. She chose to be quiet on this matter, or she did not want to create unpleasantness in the house by complaining about it. So what do you think is the correct answer? Children, don't tell me D option, because I don't remember which option was A or B or C or D. So tell me the, like, Japan Jyoti, you are right. Yes, Aryan Talwar, you give answer. Unmute yourself, Aryan Talwar. Aryan Talwar. Aryan Talwar. Children, when I ask you to speak up, then doesn't matter if you don't know the question, doesn't matter. At least mark your attendance. Show me that you are there and listening to me. Yes, Dhruv, give the answer. Yes, very good. So Dhruv, who is sitting in the class, he is correct. And moreover, this Chapanjot also said the same thing. She chose to be quiet. Okay, why this is correct answer? If we say that she did not want to create unpleasantness in the house, then it means that otherwise she might have spoken up. It means that we have not understood the character of grandmother. Grandmother did not speak anything to the grandson because she did not want to speak anything on this matter about which she did not like. She chose to be quiet on this issue. Okay, she did not create any unpleasantness in the house. She did not question anyone. She let everyone enjoy the freedom. She did not restrict anyone because of her own ideals. That is why we can say that she is an ideal lady. That's why we say she is a lady. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, whom we call as lady? The one who is educated, the one who shows the characteristics of a lady. Okay, we'll discuss it later on. Why a lady? Why is she not called as woman? Portrait of a woman. Why not woman? So try to find out the difference between a lady and a woman, and why is she a lady, not a woman? Got it? So here the answer was that she chose to be quiet on this matter because she was not the kind of person who would create a fuss on any issue. She was a serene and tranquil person who was at peace within herself. She was at peace within herself and around, out. Okay, it's not that she had peace from within, but outside she would see the disturbance, then she would become disturbed. No, the peace from within made her have peace all around also. Okay, she never got disturbed because of what was happening outside. That's why the grandson, okay, let me ask you a question. So the grandson and grandmother, when grandson was going abroad for 5 years, then grandmother accompanied him to the railway station, right? Am I right? She accompanied the family to railway station to see off the grandson. And when the grandson was going away, the grandmother was still doing prayers she was still reciting prayers and she was telling the beads on her rosary, right? When her grandson was going abroad for 5 years, even at that time, when she was telling beads on her rosary and was reciting her prayers. My question is, does it show that the grandmother had become number one? Does it show that grandmother did not love her grandson that much? Second, does it show that the grandmother had no emotions for her grandson now? Does it show that the grandmother had become very annoyed with the grandson that he was going abroad? Number four, she did not let circumstances affect her peace of mind. What will be the answer? What will be the answer? Okay, can somebody repeat all the options which I spoke right now? Yes, Chapanjot, correct. Yes, Riddhi, correct. Yes, Vriti, correct. Vriti, I don't remember whether I spoke this D part or not. Yes, Vriti, correct. Jatin, yes. Yashika, yes. So did I say, was the fourth option that she did not let circumstances affect her routine, affect her peace of mind? Was it the fourth option? Yes. So the option that she did not let her she did not let the circumstances affect her peace of mind. That was the correct option, yes. So she did not let the circumstances affect her peace of mind. And why was it so? Because she was a very spiritually strong woman. Her spirituality had made her serene and strong also. So she was never ever emotionally disturbed. Okay, one last question, then the time is also going to be over. Children, let me make it very clear. It's not that I am asking you very important questions or very less important questions. My purpose of these kinds of questions is to tell you that you are to read your chapters, not just from the literal point of view, but also from the symbolic or the or deeper level. You must try to understand like what's the in-depth meaning of the lines or the context is. Okay, last but not the least, one question. The death of mother, when the mother died, when the grandmother died, what kind of death she had? So what kind of death grandmother had? Number one, a serene death, a death followed by illness. Number three, a death the contented death. Contented means satisfied. Contented death. And number four, unexpected death. Right? Serene death. Okay, Yashika says serene. Okay? Contented. Okay, who says unexpected? No, beta. Unexpected is totally wrong option. Death is always unpredictable. Okay, death is never ever expected. You can never say like, yes, death is expected. Sometimes the person who is about to die becomes all right, miraculously. And sometimes it happens the opposite. Okay, we'll discuss this answer tomorrow. You people search it. Okay, because there are three options which are correct. Out of these three, you have to find the best one. Okay, be ready for the test today in the evening and prepare the chapters accordingly. Read the chapters thoroughly. Okay, it will be an MCQ based.